This week in reading, we're going to learn one thing that good readers do before, during, and after reading. That thing is ask and answer questions about the text. Readers do this so that they can get information and so that they can better understand what they're reading. So, how do they do that? Well, they're going to use question words like who, what, where, why, when, and how. And in order to answer those questions, they're going to look at the text, which is the words on the page, and look at the pictures for clues or evidence to help them answer the questions that they've come up with. So to show you how good readers use this strategy, I've got a short little poem to read you today called Skeleton. And before I ever read the poem, I'm just going to take a look at the picture, take a look at the title, and come up with some questions I have about this poem. One question I have right off the top is, what is a skeleton? Another question I have is, why is there a picture of bones on the page? So as I read, hopefully we'll come up with an answer for both of those questions. Let's read the poem together. Skeleton. It's made of bones. It grows with you. It helps you dance. It helps you chew. Without it, you would be a blob. Be glad your skeleton does its job. So as I was reading, I had a question. It says my skeleton grows with me. How does your skeleton grow with you? So while I was reading, I was thinking, what in the world do they mean that my skeleton grows with me? And I think what they must mean is that my bones grow as my body grows. So as my body got bigger from a baby to a kid to a grown-up, my bones also got bigger. All right, now, I've read the poem, so I'm going to go back to those questions I had at the beginning and see if I can answer them. So my first question was, what is a skeleton? I can use the picture on the page and the words that I read to help me answer what is a skeleton. And based on this poem, I think a skeleton is just the bones inside your body. My other question was, why is there a picture of bones on the page? Well, that's because a skeleton is made of bones. So I used the words and I used the pictures together to help me understand what I was reading. I asked questions before I read, while I was reading, and after I read, and I used the words and the pictures to answer those questions. As you're reading this week, I want you to think of some questions before you read a book, think of questions while you're reading, and then go back to those before reading questions at the end and see if you've come up with some answers.